Welcome back. Things are quite tense at Tip Top Trading today. Paul, the boss, mistakenly thinks Anna's been smoking on company premises, and she's trying to explain herself.
But...
Frankly, I'm disappointed with you, Anna. You are a hard worker, but it doesn't mean you can go against company policy.
Anna, remember the phrases we've learnt about a misunderstanding.
Oh, yes. Paul, I think there's been a misunderstanding.
A misunderstanding? How can you explain the smell of cigarette smoke? This is a no-smoking building.
Let me explain. I went down to the warehouse to speak to Mr. Ingle, and, well, someone else was smoking.
What? Someone was smoking in the warehouse? Golly gosh, that's highly dangerous. Who was it, Anna?
Well, I can't really say, but I dealt with it and it won't happen again.
Yes, you dealt with it very well, Anna, but can you keep your secret about Mr. Ingle safe?
Thank you, Anna. And sorry about the misunderstanding. Would you like a biscuit? Now, I really think it's time we had a review of our health and safety procedures. Denise, could you gather everyone around in the meeting room, please?
I'd have to call you back, Marge. Could you all gather in the meeting room, please? Paul has something important to say.
What is it, Denise? Is it about my fantastic sales figures again, huh?
I doubt it, Tom. It sounded urgent. I'd better bring some tea.
Thank you for joining me. Unfortunately, there has been an incident in the warehouse. Someone has been smoking, and I'm not happy. So I thought I would remind you of our health and safety procedures.
Oh, not this again.
Your safety is our responsibility, but to keep safe, we must follow some simple rules. Denise, what's the first one?
If you see a fire, raise the alarm. Oh, and call the fire service.
Yeah, you love seeing those firemen, don't you, Denise?
Shh, Tom. Maybe you could tell us the other rule.
Right. If you hear the fire alarm, get out quick.
Not exactly, Tom, no. I think we should walk calmly to our nearest fire exit, following the green signs, go outside and meet at the fire assembly point.
Yes, and I will take the register of who is here using my red pen.
Do you mind not slurping, Denise?
This is thirsty work.
Now, is everyone clear about what to do if there is a fire alarm?
Well, it's usually a false alarm anyway.
That's not the point. Now, Anna, what about smoking?
No smoking on company premises. But it wasn't me. It was Mr. Ingle.
Mr. Ingle.
I see. So it was Mr. Ingle smoking in the warehouse. You should have told me, Anna.
Sorry.
Right, I'm going to have to look into this. Back to work, everyone. Oh, and take a biscuit with you.
So Anna's let the cat out of the bag. Mr. Ingle won't be pleased, but at least she now knows what to do if a fire breaks out. Here are some of the phrases we've heard today that can be used in an emergency.
If you see a fire, raise the alarm.
Walk calmly to your nearest fire exit.
Meet at the fire assembly point.
No smoking on company premises.
Sorry to interrupt, Paul, but the fire alarm's going off.
Don't panic, anyone. Everything will be okay. Jane, I'll have to call you back. Yes, bit of a panic. Bye. Quick, where's my red pen?
Uh-oh, those emergency phrases might come in useful sooner than you think. Is this going to be the end of Tip Top Trading? Will it really go up in smoke? Find out next time. Bye.